It's time to kick off the most important part of 2019 Ball Hockey World Championships in Stylaria Košice, as in women's part of the tournament, Slovakia takes on Canada in a do-or-die match for a place in tomorrow's finals. When I've said do-or-die, it means for Slovakia is obviously Canada has already secured their spot in the final by beating USA in regulation. And they can obviously use this match as a great test for tomorrow, or even as a preparation, because it is quite possible that both teams will meet again tomorrow. Here are the rosters of both teams. Slovakia in blue jerseys, already on the blue line, lined up, ready to take on Canada, who is just now arriving onto the field. Canada in red combinations. So an interesting match awaits, and really an important one for a host country, which is obviously Slovakia. Slovak women could have secured the place in the final by beating USA in yesterday's game, but they could not do it as they lost in overtime, and that means that Slovaks will have to earn their way in the final. In this match instead, they only need 2 points, since they already have one. USA has played both these teams in the final three, so USA women can do nothing about it. They can only watch and hope that Canada beats Slovakia in any fashion. So the map is pretty simple for this one. In the net for Canada, it is Juliana Thompson, number one, and for Slovakia, Dominika Tabačková, ready to go. So Natalie Girouard takes a break from this game. Here you can see her, a number one goaltender for most of the games at this year's Women's Ball Hockey World Championships. So everything is ready for the start of the last game of this stage of the tournament, as tomorrow only third place game and a gold medal game will be played. So let's see whether Slovakia will battle for bronze tomorrow or for gold with the same opponent as today. Obviously stakes are pretty huge and everything is ready for an opening face-off. Surakova ready to take it against Karpenko, and here we go. Slovakia wins the face-off and immediately they can set up the attack. Ball is dumped in behind the net where Juliana Thompson gets it on the forecheck. Slovaks are immediately aggressive. They want to get the ball back as soon as possible. Now it bounces into the neutral zone and Canada takes it. Dunlop, she tries to deke her way through, but Slovaks take it only momentarily as a bad pass almost intercepted by Petra Pravlíková. And now Slovaks battle it out, and they didn't make a great pass, so Margot Sharp can take it the other way. Now Regan Fischer, she's got some open space and she shoots, and a first save by Dominika Tabačková in Slovakia's net. Now another snapshot from the point gets blocked. Canada still on the ball in the offensive zone with a minute and 15 seconds already gone from the first period. Now a good stick by Alexandra Turčaniová, only for a moment. Slovakia had it now. Another shot, this time by Regan Fischer, who controls along the boards. She's got open teammates. But she takes it herself, and now she puts it on the net where Dominika Tabačková had to be sharp. She had to get out of her zone and cover for a whistle. So a first dangerous situation in front of Slovakia's goaltender, as Eddie Brenning was ready to bury the rebound. So a good start for Canada. They have possession once again in the offensive zone. Dontalk on the forecheck, and now Slovakia controls behind their own net. Alžbeta Šulíková puts it around the board for Nikola Němčeková, and it's dumped in. And now a first save sort of for Juliana Thompson, who covers for a draw. Canada had 10 points in the group stage of the tournament. Slovakia finished second, only behind the Maple Leafs with 8 points, and USA was third with 7, and Czech Republic finished fourth, and it is already awaiting its opponent, whether it will be Slovakia or USA for bronze medal. Czechs have managed to beat Great Britain in both games, and they will have the opportunity to compete for bronze at least, although they certainly had higher ambitions before the tournament. Now Slovakia settles down behind the net. Gabriela Žitňanská is looking for a first pass. She puts it in along the red line. Now a stoppage in play. This Jessica McCann was the last one to touch it, and a face-off should come all the way down or only to the neutral zone, where Slovakia wins it, and they dump it in. Martina Staroňová battling in the corner, but now she's stripped off the ball. And Danielle Ring gets it. She makes a good pass. Jessica McCann now with it. She protects the ball well with her body, and now she's got some open space. McCann, she leaves it up for her defenseman. Now Ring has to reach for it, and still Canadians. Tara Swanson put it deep, where Palota ended up on the ground, and Slovakia can go for a change and set up another attack. Now a good movement from Silvia Kuchanová, and now another battle along the boards. Drake wins it for Canada, but only momentarily, as home girls take it, but to no avail, as Canada going back the other way. A good job by April Drake, who gets tangled up, but no call. So Slovakia still on the ball. This time a quick transition, but could not get to Natalia Palová, who didn't control the ball for Slovakia for any longer period of time. So far it's been mostly Canada in the first. A good job by Sharp, but she loses it. And now Nina Štrbáková can take it forward, but she finds no one with this long pass, and it goes up for an icing. So play will come back in front of Dominika Tabačková, who was probably the busier of the two goaltenders, but still not many chances in the opening minutes of this game. We are still scoreless between Slovakia and Canada. For a place in the final, Canada already there, but Slovakia still very much in the balance. Now Sarah Frances turns with it. She wanted to leave it up for her teammate, but could not do it. Now this won't be an icing, as Julianna Thompson likes to cover instead of playing the ball. She made a decision for a face-off to her right, as Kara Broom goes for a change. Slovakia is victorious on the face-off, and the shot is blocked on the way to Julianna Thompson. Now, again, women in blue take it, and a dumped ball ends up in the corner. Both teams battling hard so far in the first. Now a bounced shot off of a cushion behind Julianna Thompson, and she covers as Emilia Leskovianska took a bit of a hit along the way, but she shakes it off. She was rolled over by Kristen Kuz, a 26-year-old defenseman for Team Canada. Slovakia again winning the draw. Now McCann could not reach this long pass, and another icing. So far it's been really sloppy from both sides. Not many chances, not many shots, as we await our first goal in this game. Perhaps the most important for Slovakia in the entire tournament. Canada can only use this game as a test for tomorrow. Now a shot from long distance is blocked, and Barbora Gaurikova takes it. She tries a backhander back to the point where a long shot is easily set aside by Julianna Thompson with her stick. With 8 minutes, 25 seconds to go in the first, Canada still even against Slovakia. Nothing, nothing. A good transition by Canadians, and here's some open space. And Kendra Dunlop couldn't get the ball to the net, and now Canadians will have to cross the blue line again, because they could not keep the offensive zone. Now Roma is trying to do it, but she loses possession of the ball, and Slovakia captain Petra Pravlíková waits for her teammates. Now the ball is dumped in the air and controlled by Slovakia. Another dump in, this time could not be reached with a glove hand of Martina Viličková. And now some open space the other way. Jessica McCann, she's been really dangerous in the playoffs so far in this tournament. We know she scored 4 goals against the USA in 2 games combined. 2 goals in each one. And Slovakia will really have to be careful about this player. She's been really hot and danger number one on Canadian side. Now a good chance for Slovakia, sharp angle shot ends up on top of the net, maybe even off the post. Now another pass and a backhander, which had to be stopped by Julianna Thompson, and Slovakia still aggressive on the ball. Now in the corner, Natalia Palová battling it out, and she is successful. Now Michala Haníková, Palová again, a Good shift for Slovakia. First extended period of time spent in the offensive zone, but now Canada clears and can go for a change, as well as Slovakia women with 6 minutes to go in the first. A first real opportunity for Slovakia in this game. It was from a sharp angle, but Juliana Thompson had to be really careful. Now Margot Sharp and 2-on-1 developing the other way. One Canada player is waiting for it in the slot, but it could not get to Sarah Francis. Margot Sharp trying to take the ball away from Emilia Leskovianska, but she puts it in. And now Juliana Thompson will play it. She leaves it up for Michelle Marsh, and now he transitions by Slovaks, and pass could not get to Emilia Leskovianska, who would have had an open space if it got to her. Now it ends up in between the benches for another stoppage. And let's take a look at the most serious chance from Slovakia in this game so far. And it was Tamara Dobošová who was aiming towards a goal. And she really tested Juliana Thompson. Now a chance for USA on a backhand, but good save by Dominika Tabačková on April Drake, who was going hard to the net, but she could not open the scoring yet, so we're still waiting for our first goal. Both teams have had chances so far, but no score on either side. Obviously, Slovakian fans hoping for a favorable result. They won their team battle for a gold medal tomorrow. But Slovakia needs to beat Canada first to even get to that stage. Otherwise, it's going to be Canada-USA final in the women's tournament. Now a quick break is negated by Canadians as Slovaks couldn't get the ball deep. And now Canadians do, but only for the price of icing, as April Drake couldn't reach it. And Slovakia put some fresh forces on the field as Alexandra Turčeneva makes her way into the offensive zone. Here is Canadian coach who has to be quite satisfied with the performance of his team so far in the entire tournament, as Canada has been dominant so far. Slovakia in the cycle in the offensive zone, a whack at it by Natalia Palova, but she could not get much on the shot. And now Canada on the breakaway. This will not be an icing as Danielle Ring gets to the ball. Now McCann, she hits Turčeneva and she is still battling for the ball, but Palova comes up with it. But a misunderstanding with her teammate, who gets it. After all, Emilia Leskovianska, but Melanie Ju quickly took it away from her. And now Francis, a good deke made between the legs of Alžbeta Šulíková, but it was too far already for Sarah Francis, as Dominika Tabačková covers for a draw in her zone. So a good idea by Francis, who wanted to put it on her forehand, but she was not quick enough. Now Alžbeta Šulíková takes it. She makes a first pass, but Emilia Leskovianská couldn't control it. Now battle along the red line. Again, Canada trying to transition, and now successful as Eddie Brenning is battling with Šulíková, and now she loses the ball. Chance for Slovakia the other way, only momentarily, as Canada immediately takes it away. So still a sloppy play continues on both sides. Not many good opportunities with 2 minutes to go in the first. Perhaps one chance to score for both sides so far in the first 13 minutes. Here is Team Slovakia captain Petra Pravlíková, a 34-year-old defenseman, a left-handed shot on the face of it's Brenning against Anna Suráková. And Canada gets it in the zone, but could not get the ball, as Michelle Marsh has to retrieve. She makes a good job on the pass, and then a bit of a problem for Canada getting the ball out of their own zone. So Juliana Thompson rather covers, as Marsh made a good pass, but Angie Cirelli couldn't quite control it, and it resulted in a half chance for Slovakia. Now a bounce off of a cushion, a big hit by Slovakia along the blue line. Now a possible 3-on-2, but now it goes behind the net and dumped out along the boards. Canada still keeps it. And a snapshot from the point is a high one. Now another rebound, and for Karpenko, who was there, adding a whack at it, but she could not hit ball cleanly, as Canada with a bit of pressure in the last minute of the first. Another snapshot could not be deflected by one of her teammates, as Slovakia clears for an icing. So a good shift by Canada as we are approaching the end of the first. Still no goals have been scored on either side. Danielle Rink, she loses the face-off, and a crucial one for Slovakia, as they can still try the attack the other way, and now they are in the offensive zone, as Michaela Hajníková protects the ball well, and now she on a slap shot and a rebound. A biggest chance for Slovakia so far. Tamara Dobošová was there on the far post, and she could have buried a rebound past Juliana Thompson, but she really stood tall on this chance. A hard snapshot was even deflected in front of Thompson, and she did well on the rebound of Dobošová as well. So, after 15 minutes in a Steel Arena, and this a very important match, we are still tied, nothing. We are back in Steel Arena Košice for a second period of this very important game, especially for Slovakia as they battle for their place in the final against Canada. Obviously, Canada is already in a gold medal game. And so far, it's been pretty uneventful first period as not many chances on either side in the first. Maybe a rebound in the dying seconds of the first, which Juliana Thompson covered, was the biggest chance for Slovakia. USA had a couple of breakaways, but they could not bury them. So far, we are still playing without a penalty on either side, which is also quite surprising given the importance of this game. Not a lot of whistles. As Slovakia now could not get it out of their own zone, and Canada controls. Shot from the point is wide as McKenna tries to get the rebound, and now a dumped ball but not out, as Canada with a good keep in the zone. Danielle Ring got hit along the boards and she was slow to get up. Now she gets back to her feet as Canada still the offensive zone during the first minute and a half. And now Slovakia just clears the ball and goes for a change. Not a good start for Slovakia. Obviously they feel the pressure because it's their last chance to get to the gold medal game. We already know that Czech Republic will not defend its title from 2 years ago. And we'll have a new world champion in ball hockey in the women's part of the tournament. In the men's part, it is still to be determined, as both men's semifinals are still upon us, as Slovakia will take on Canada once again, this time in the men's part of the tournament. And the second semifinal is going to be a battle between Czech Republic and Finland. Now back to the pitch as Canada scores on the breakaway. It is Margot Sharp who puts it past Dominika Tabačková. She got a great pass from the red line, and she capitalized on a lot of open space as Alexandra Tručanová was late for her coverage. But a great pass from Regan Fisher right onto the stick of Margot Sharp, a 28-year-old forward, who makes it 1-0 Canada in 17th minute of this game. So a first really big chance in this game, and it is it means a goal for US for Canada, who take the lead. And now Slovakia is under even bigger pressure as they now need to tie it up as quickly as possible. I mentioned that Slovakia needs any kind of victory, whether in OT or in regulation or even in the shootout. Now an icing as Karpenko couldn't get to the ball. So not a good start to the second for Slovakia, as they're having a tough time to get past Canada's defense, which has been impressive in the tournament so far. Even their goaltending has been great. Now a 2-on-1. As Dunlop is waiting for the pass. Now a sharp angle shot and a rebound Tabachkova was able to stop it from April Drake as Dunlop was waiting in front of the crease for a pass. Now she gets it. Another great opportunity for Canadians to make it 2-0, and that would have been crucial in a close game like this. Now Žitňanská is able to come up with it. Slovakia needs to settle down because it's been really sloppy from them so far in this game. Melanie Jew controls the ball, but she did not get much on this pass. Now Tara Swanson gets it back to her. Melanie Jew, she's been the player of the game in the last encounter against USA. This will be an offside on Slovakia as Laborska couldn't quite reach it. Slovaks really need to get their act together in the second if they want to get back in this game. So far, nothing doing in front of Juliana Thompson, who really didn't have much work. It's been all Canada. Now Palota almost got the ball on the breakaway. Another one of that. There have been many rushes by Canadians so far in this game. Another draw in the neutral zone, this time controlled by McCann, but she could not find Palota. Now with Daniel Ring had a whack at it, and she goes on the forecheck as Petra Pravlíková gets it. Another long pass. It will be an icing at last, even though the referee was waiting for a long time. As Natalia Palova is on her way into the game. So a top line for Slovakia against the top line of Canada. And now it looks like a ball got stuck into the back side of the net. So a little scare for home fans as this shot almost ended up into the back of the net. Now another opportunity for Canada. A backhander by Nicole Latrey is stopped and blocked in front of the net. No penalty on this play as Slovakia only clears, but they are aggressive on the forecheck. And an open woman in front. It was Staroňová, and now another chance for Slovakia, and this time it gets covered by Juliana Thompson. So first the real work for her in the second, as the ball was put in front, and Dobošová was waiting for a rebound, but it never came. But maybe this will serve as a wake-up call for Slovakia. A great shift on their part in the last seconds, and maybe they can build on it going further in this game. Now they are still on the ball. Emilia Leskovianská, she put it deep into the corner where a collision between Marsh and Nikola Nemčeková. Now Canada was trying to transition. Now they're able to do it, but only for Margot Sharp, who along with her teammate dumped it in and go for a change. As Nikola Nemčeková waits for her teammates to complete the change, now she leaves it up for Patricia Dzurinová. A bad pass on the blue line, and now it gets cleared all the way behind the net of Juliana Thompson, who's had to work on that last situation where Slovakia threatened her goal, but still the Slovaks were not able to put the ball past Juliana Thompson, an 18-year-old goalkeeper. She's really young and she's been the backup to Natalie Girouard, a 44-year-old, so big age difference between the two netminders for Canada. Now a hard drive to the net by Eddie Brenning, and she was hooked on the play. So a first power play coming up for Canada. As Zuzana Kolcunova is going to the box. Not much question about it, as Brenning was already in a good position in front of Dominika Tabačková, and now Slovakia will have to defend against an advantage, as Canada immediately is able to set up its power play formation. Slovakia cannot allow Canada to score another goal, because it would be really long way back into the game if Canada scored. From a sharp angle, Karpenko took a shot, but now Melanie Jew from the point. A hard shot and a rebound by Karpenko. It gets deflected into the corner. Luckily for Slovakia, still no score for Canada. Now Michelle Marsh, she fires and a rebound and a great save by Tabačková. It's been the best one so far for Slovakia's netminder. She's really made a huge stop on Canada, as it looked like a clear goal on their part. Now Melanie Jew controls, still another minute to go on the power play. A good pass, but Regan Fischer has to control it further, and now Slovakia clears. They can go for a change. Will definitely get back to the great save by Dominika Tabačková when the play is stopped, which is now, because Canada is offside. This is the woman who kept Canada's lead to a one goal, as she stopped Chelsea Karpenko with her stick. One of the saves of the tournament so far, and that is definitely not an overstatement due to the importance of this save by 20-year-old goalkeeper in Slovakia's net. Now face off in the neutral zone, Eddie Brenning wins it, and Jessica McCann has to retrieve. A long pass along the red line is now gets back to Kristin Kuz, who dumps it in. But she did not get it past the blue line. Slovakia on the forecheck, and a great job by Tamara Dobošová now. Brenning with some open space the other way. Still Eddie Brenning. Now Canada's power play is over. They've had one big rebound opportunity, but could not score, as Slovakia has defended their first man advantage in this game to keep it 1-0 Canada. And now they can start thinking about the attack. But it's hard to argue that Canada has been the better side so far in the first half of this game. Slovakia needs to find their way quickly if they want to make it to gold medal contest against the same opponent. Now Daniel Ring on the forecheck. She gets the ball. Passes it to Palota, but it could not get to her. Slovakia the other way. As Kristina Šimnová is on the forecheck. Now she's joined by Emilia Leskovianska. But Canadians comfortably are able to pass the puck. pass the ball along themselves. And now another whistle. As Kara Brum communicates with Nicola Trey, her defensive partner. Face off controlled by Slovaks, who dump it in on a snapshot, and it gets covered with a blocker of Juliana Thompson. Martina Raškova wins the face-off and a hard shot and a rebound, a chance for Slovakia. It goes wide of the net. But definitely one of the bigger chances so far in this period for Slovakia, as McCann is on the ball, battling with Žitňanská now. She's joined by Daniel Ring, but Raškova does a good job of helping her. Now a little scramble, but everything is okay between Gabriela Žitňanská and Jessica McCann. Let's take a look again at this snapshot and rebound by Staroňová, who had quite a lot on the shot, but she could not get it past Juliana Thompson. And now both women will go to the box, I think, for 2 minutes, as we're gonna see 4-on-4 ball hockey for the next 2 minutes, as Žitňanská and presumably McCann are in the box. But let's wait for a confirmation. Yes, it's a 4-on-4 for the next couple of seconds. Let's see who takes advantage of more space on the pitch, as Petra Pravlíková had a chance to clear. Now it gets back into Canada's zone. Another real forecheck by Slovaks. A long pass to Dunlop, who tries to turn with it, and she does. She finds an open space, and Chelsea Karpenko, she got her stick held up, and now a backhanded chance for Dunlop, as she's joined by Mitchell March, and she takes a hard shot, which bounced off a glove of Tabačková. Now still Canada, as Mitchell March passes on a one-timer to Kendra Dunlop, who missed the net, but she's on it again. Dunlop gets it back. Now a point shot, a hard one, and Dunlop on the rebound. So 4-on-4 so far, better suited for Canada, it looks like, with another 30 seconds to go. With 4-on-4 ball hockey, as Canada controls. Now it's dumped deep into the zone, and April Drake gets after it. A point shot from Kuz is covered by Dominika Tabačková, who's been the hero for Slovakia so far, stopping many good chances of women in red jerseys. And even this one was no problem for Slovakia's netminder. Strbáková puts it behind the net. Not as many times before, Canada is able to win a ball battle. The bounces are going their way, but obviously they are showing great speed and determination in the ball battles so far, and they've been the better side, and there's a really lead 1-0, as Slovakia is still in this game, trying hard. Now Jessica McCann along the boards. She tried to put it to the center of the rink, but it bounced out of the zone. April Drake put it back in there, only to the stick of Nina Štrbáková, who sets up the attack, and now a bit of an open space for Slovaks, and a good dig. Too bad for Tamara Dobošová that she could not reach the ball. She would have been all alone against Juliana Thompson, who now saves a point shot for another draw. But let's take a look again at the great deke by Tamara Dobošová, who was speedy enough, but in the end it was Juliana Palota who got her stick on the ball to get it away from Tamara Dobošová. It was a really a crucial defensive play. Now Margot Sharp, she's running hard after the ball, but she could not reach it and get a shot off. Now she leaves it for Karpenko, puts it on the point, a deflection by Sharp. Now a backhander and another whack at it by Canadians. And another backhander. And now a rebound opportunity for Sarah Francis, who was in front of the net. Still Canada on the ball. But now a bad pass and Lucia Záborská put it out of her zone. And now a 3-on-2 for Slovakia. But after a long change, not much energy remained for Slovakia women as they now go for a change. At least an offensive zone face-off won by Kristýna Šimnová, who was running hard even when Juliana Thompson covered the ball. So still another minute and a half to go in the second. Slovakia trailing Canada by one, but definitely still very much in this game. The ball goes deep where Canada plays it. And a good job of forechecking by Slovakia, but Silvia Kochanová could not get a shot off. Now Žitňanská, she protects the ball well and she puts it on the net, where Kochanová could not get a rebound or a deflection. Now another collision in the neutral zone as Palota takes it deep into the offensive zone. She has McCann with her, or rather Michelle Marsh, or Daniel Ring, excuse me, who is battling with Žurinová. Now Palota gets it behind net, but she gets hit by Suráková. Canada still on the ball. Palota, she exchanges the ball with her teammate Dawn Talk, turns with it, and now a second period comes to an end, even though there might be a penalty and an unnecessary one for Slovakia in the dying seconds of this period, as Anna Maria Suráková will head to the box when we begin the second. So a bad penalty on Slovakia's side as they will begin the third shorthanded. Now this is the only goal that has been scored in this game so far, and Margot Sharp put the ball past Dominika Tabačková. So after 30 minutes in Steel Arena, Canada leads Slovakia 1-0. Just before the start of the third period in this game between Slovakia and Canada, you could take a look at some of the statistics. As Surakova will sit in the box for the opening 2 minutes of the third period, or at least it looks like that, unless Canada scores to make it 2-0. So definitely not an ideal way to start the third period for Slovakia. And Canada with a second advantage in this game. Slovakia still without a power play. There's been one 4-on-4 so far in the second. But now, chance for McCann. She's got Fischer on the wing, now back to McCann on the point. And a one-timer from the wing, it goes wide. Arpenko makes the play to McCann. She fires from long distance and on the rebound or deflection, there was Regan Fischer, but she could not get her stick on the ball. Now Margot Sharp, the goal scorer. One-timer by McCann, it gets blocked. Karpenko, she settles it down. Back to McCann. Karpenko, she's got a one-timer. Good block by Slovakia. Now Sharp back to the point. 40 seconds remain on the power play. Kristin Kuz is on the right wing. McCann, Kuz are ready for a one-timer. Now she's got the ball and she scores to make it 2-0. Kristin Kuz with a second goal for Canada on a one-timer on the power play as Canada makes it 2-0, and this is not looking good for Slovakia as Kristin Kuz fired one home past Dominika Tabačková. She was ready for the shot a long time before the pass even got to her, but Kuz showed off her great one-timer as a right-handed shot. She got it served up on a platter. But during the entire power play, Canada had possession of the ball. And at last, they were able to make it a two-goal game with 13 minutes, 15 seconds to go in the third. Slovakia needs to start thinking about offense, but still they have to defend as in good position. There was Don Talk who tested Dominika Tabačková. She's made some great saves, especially in the second on the rebound of Chelsea Karpenko. She's not really been at fault for any of the goals scored by Canada so far. But Slovakia is still not able to produce on offense. Now, Nina Štrbáková, she dumps the ball out of play. Nina Štrbáková is still only 15 years old. Youngest player in the game on both sides today. A big talent, but other than that, Slovakia has another 15-year-old in Emilia Leskovianska and a couple of 17-year-olds, so a young squad for Slovakia. Still battling it out against Canada on the big stage. Battling for a chance to go into the final. But right now it looks like a bronze medal match awaits for Slovakia against Czech Republic. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. We still have another 12 and a half minutes to go. Shot is blocked. Slovakia trying to start the attack, but they were not successful. Daniel Rink puts it in the corner where Palota's got it. Back to McCann, and a good play from Lucia Záborská. And now Alžbeta Šulíková. She clears the ball only for an icing, so still not a lot of offense for Slovakia. So far they've been unable to control the ball for longer periods of time. There have been a few great shifts from the women in blue, but still time for them to tie this one up or at least score to make it a one goal game. Now Margot Sharp turns into the offensive zone, but she's held by Dušáková now. Karabrun could not reach it. And Slovakia has to go on the forecheck as a good job by Staroňová. But it bounced back onto Canadian sticks. As they certainly can take their time with this pass, having a two-goal advantage, but it goes nowhere, only for an icing. With 11 minutes, 9 seconds to go in the third period of this important game for Slovakia, not so much for Canada. But still, they really took this game responsibly as they are on top of their opponents tonight in the Steel Arena so far. Now a good control behind the net from Slovakia. After some time, they have a chance to set up the attack, and a shot is blocked in front of Juliana Thompson. So far, she didn't have to make any saves in the third. As on the forecheck, there's April Drake, who is held by Alexandra Gáborčíková. Now Kendra Dunlop takes it. She tried to turn towards the center, and a breakoff chance for Slovakia goes nowhere. As Tamara Dobošová is on the forecheck, but Michelle Marsh was able to turn with it. Now again deep in the zone. Dobošová battling, and now she's joined by one of her teammates, and they come up with the ball. Natalia Palová now passes it back along the boards, and a collision back in Canada's zone. No whistle is gone. Now a kicked pass only to the stick of Palova, who dumps it in as Leskovianska runs after it, but Thompson was there to play it. Canada definitely in control of this game still, with 9 minutes to go. Dumped out by Karabrum. As another chance to get set up, and a good deke and an open space, even a rebound, but Thompson with a great save. This was definitely the biggest opportunity for Slovakia in the third so far. Let's take a look at it again, as Žitňanská had quite some open space, and on the rebound there was Nikola Nemčeková, who tried to bury the rebound past Juliana Thompson, but she's still keeping it scoreless for Slovakia. She's been able to stop all the shots that have come her way so far in this game. Now Melanie Drew, she tried a long pass, but Danielle Ring could not reach it. And now a penalty is going to be called, and it's going to go against Canada. So for the first time today, Canada is going to be shorthanded, as Danielle Ring is headed to the box. A 24-year-old forward for Team Canada will sit for a deuce, as a great opportunity for Slovakia to get back in this game. Maybe one of the last chances, because time is quickly running out for Slovakia. The ball is deep, but in on Canadian sticks. Clearance along the boards is not successful, as Slovakia controls. Petra Pravlíková, the captain, battling with Palová, and they come up with the ball. Rašková, but there is nobody home in the slot. Žitňanská now gets it. A shot on a one-timer. Palová was trying to deflect it onto the net of Juliana Thompson, who covers in the end for a draw. So we first stoppage in play on this power play, as Thompson is a little bit slow to get up, but now she is ready to go, as well as her teammates. They need to kill off another minute and 30 seconds on the power play. Some technical difficulties. Now we are back in the Steel Arena for a second try on Slovakia's power play. Still no goals have been scored. We have not missed anything. Now a long point shot, and the net is off, as Juliana Thompson gets it back into place. Both teams go for a change. Still 2-0 Canada. On goals by Margot Sharp and Kristin Kuz. Face-off won by Slovaks, who try in the shot. And now Canada back to full strength. So a successful penalty kill for Canada. Francis in the offensive zone, but she could not get into the middle of the ring. Now a dumped ball, but first one to it is gonna be Tara Swanson. Fisher. Now Francis, good job of turning with it. She gets it back from Sharp, and Francis is already in the offensive zone. Now Sharp joins her. McCann is in front of the net. Now from the point, a hard shot, but the way wide from Melanie Ju. Kristen Kuz, the goal scorer from this period, now with it. Ju, she's got some open space. She finds April Drake. Another chance for Ju. A hard shot from Kuz, it goes. And a weird bounce from the boards. And back in front of the net of Dominika Tabachkova. So a good shift for Canada with 5 minutes and 10 seconds to go in the third. Time is running out for Slovakia, who go for a change. At least three of them do. Now McCann still on the ball. Great shift by Canadians, who control this game from start to up until this point. A good opportunity for Jessica McCann, who was left all alone in front of Tabachkova. Now chance the other way. Good job by Tamara Dobošová. She's got an open teammate in front. It was Palova, who could not get much on the shot, unfortunately for Slovakia. Another point shot, it goes wide. Chased up by Tamara Dobošová. She's got her teammate deep, but could not get it past Canadians. Kristen Kuz made a great play as Pavlikova was waiting for it. Now Danielle Ring battling it out. Dobošová battling for it. Now Canada controls behind their own net. Pavlikova on the forecheck. She didn't want to allow Canadians to make an easy first pass. Now a sprint for it, and April Drake is the first one on the ball. Now she puts it in front, and a one-time opportunity for, I think it was Karpenko, who was left alone in the crease. Now Karpenko back to the point. But this is where Canada wants to play at this stage of the game. Now a mistake by Canadians, and another call. So you can see what can a sloppy pass lead to. This time it led to a penalty, as Nicole Latre will sit for a tripping with 3.5 minutes to go in this period. And it's definitely one of the last chances for Slovakia to do something about this game, as Emilia Leskovianska drew a penalty on Canada. So with 3 minutes and 10 seconds to go, maybe even Dominika Tabachkova will head to the bench for an extra attacker and a 6-on-4 advantage. We'll see. Now it's still a regular 5-on-4 power play for Slovakia. A second one in 3 minutes time, but they still could not score. Now a bad pass, and Canada can get it out, as Angie Cirelli does just that. Zurinova chases the ball. The time is quickly running out for Slovakia. Maybe we'll see Dominika Tabachkova on the bench very soon. There is nothing to wait for Slovakia. Now a clearing attempt, it goes only to the blue line. Zurinova, she shoots and it gets blocked. And Canada clears, this time a good job from Michel Marsh. And Canada still on the forecheck as April Drake does a great job. We are now into the last 2 minutes of the game, and only 30 seconds remained on the penalty of Nicole Latre. And now Juliana Thompson wanted to get the ball out of her glove before the whistle went, but she could not manage to do it. So a stoppage in play and another face-off in Slovakia's offensive zone. We'll see whether there are six players in the game for Slovakia. It looks like still that is not the case. And Melanie Ju on a backhander, she tries to clear. Good play from Slovakia now. They're still battling along the blue line now, back into Slovakia zone as Nicola Trace penalty comes to an end. And now it certainly looks like Canada will play in the final against USA. Only a minute and a couple of seconds to go in the third. Dominika Tabačková still in the net. And a bad pass only to Daniel Ring, who deeks, and she could not get it, as Nikola Němčeková was there to intercept. Canada is leaving no doubt that it belongs in the final this year. They've been the better side today and they deservedly lead 2-0, especially on defense. They've been pretty dominant in this tournament. Now another intercept as Daniel Rink puts it deep. She's got April Drake with her. With 15 seconds to go, Drake maneuvers in the offensive zone, and now she's in a battle with Palova, and Pravlikova takes it. Only a couple of seconds to go, and now it is clear that Canada will face USA in a battle for gold medal tomorrow here in Steel Arena, as Slovakia will only play for a bronze medal. Certainly now it's a disappointment, but Slovakia quickly needs to regroup and focus on the game against Czech Republic. So let's take a look at the goals which decided this game. They were scored by Margot Sharp and Kristen Kuz. As disappointment looms among Slovakians. Meanwhile, Canada already knew that they'll play in the final. The only question was who their opponent is gonna be. And it is now certain it will not be Slovakia. Now the goals. Margot Sharp, she made a good run past Nina Štrbáková. And she scored on the blocker of Dominika Tabačková. And the second goal came on the power play in the third period on a one-timer by Kristin Kuz, who put it past this woman, who is obviously very disappointed. Which is understandable. But as I've said, Slovakia needs to regroup and get ready for tomorrow. Still a bronze medal is waiting to be grabbed. Now the best players on each side will be awarded. The best player on the For Slovakia, it's Lucia Záborská, a 20-year-old defenseman, a right-handed shot who takes home the prize. A disappointment on her face as well. And at least a little consolation prize. And on the other side, Juliana Thompson, a goaltender who takes it. Another clean sheet for Canada in today's game, this time courtesy of Juliana Thompson, not Nathalie Girard. We'll see who will be in the net for Canada tomorrow in the final, but we assume it's going to be Nathalie Girard, who's got more experience. And now it's time to listen to the national anthem of Canada. So a traditional handshake line for both teams as Slovakia will have one more game left, as well as Canada, in this tournament. Both of these squads will have a chance for a medal. Canada will battle it out for gold tomorrow, and Slovakia for a bronze with Czech Republic. So it's time to say goodbye for now, but don't leave us, as we still await two men's semi-final games, Canada against Slovakia and Czech Republic against Finland. We look forward to you joining us once again on Boosted TV. See you soon.